Welcome, rebellious generals. This is the Battle of Chantilly in the Confederate campaign on Major General Difficulty in version 1.28.4 of the J&P Mod. How does 14,000 captures at a side battle sound? Things went very well at Chantilly. But first, I want to say thank you for taking the time to check out any of my materials related to the game. I hope that you find something to help you achieve success in your own campaigns. Do not hesitate to ask questions in the comments. Be aware that Colonel, Brigadier General, and Major General difficulties all share an AI profile, whereas Legendary has its own profile. Therefore, things that you see me do should easily translate to lower difficulties but may not work in Legendary or be suboptimal. My career point from Weapons Factory went into training, as will my point from Chantilly. AI scaling is increasing for Chantilly and Antietam, so I have increased my unit size for this battle. I expect the AI infantry units to be over 3,000 men, and they will bring a heavy dose of charges. I will be on the defensive in the first half of the battle, so I'm going heavy on infantry units with 11. I'm also bringing my three best smoothbore artillery and two melee cav units. My focus here is on breaking charges and holding the two VPs. Hill is the corps commander. Longstreet has the 1st Division with Wilcox, Taliaferro, Seams, and Cabell. McLaws has the 2nd Division with Latimer, Sedgwick, and Scribner. Preston has the 3rd Division with Pugh, Rhodes, and Peabody. Beauregard has the 4th Division with Siegfried, Skirmer, and Ford. Ferrero has the 5th Division with Jackson, Nicholas, and Hobson. The AI has received another full corps reinforcement. That increases the intelligent report numbers by about 9,000 troops, 1% each for training and armory. The AI will have 35,926 troops and 84 guns plus any unit splits. I have 24,820 troops and 44 guns. Not counting unit splits, the AI will have 8 infantry, 3 skirmishers, and 2 artillery units. That means that each battery will have 42 guns, so those are massive. Deployment starts with 10 units, but the other 6 will deploy right after the battle starts. My strategy for this battle is to heavily defend the VP on the right side of the screen while flanking from left to right just south of the VP on the left side. It'll be a little bit of a balancing act to keep enough units on the right side to hold the VP and the farm in the center while having enough guys to flank. I want to push the AI out of the woods to the south of my right flank to get them out into the open. Then, just like Weapons Factory, once they're all out in the open and taking heavy fire, I want to get as many wavering as possible and charge them at the end. The fortifications in the mod are much better than the ones in the base game. However, you still have the issue of multiple enemy units firing on whoever's in the fortifications. So I prefer to have my guys stay in cover near the fortifications and then jump into them when being charged for the melee bonus. The exception on this map is the one that's near the right VP, since a unit can be in that fortification and fire while other units are in the woods right in front of it. The message says that a Yankee division is attacking, but the AI is going to have three corps commanders on this field, so I'm not sure how that works. Here comes the first charge, which is a good thing since this is the infantry unit that I want to route first, along with the dedicated skirmishers that are in this area. I will have Rhodes fall back to give my cav more time to get there and support. Oops, he stopped his charge. He's screwed now. I'll get him routing and I'll send both my melee cav for the surrender or shatter. Thank you. I hate my KF being in melee this long, but if Nagel goes down, my flank attack will be off to a great start. The next charge is started. He stopped when Rhodes moved into the fortification, but I'm sure that one of the units near Kearney will charge soon. Nagel went down, and I can snag that supply wagon. That dedicated skirmisher is isolated to the left, so I can take him out too. In hindsight, my 24-pound howitzer battery's in a bad spot there and ends up taking some heavy damage. Fortunately, I have 3 or 4 more guns in my armory to replace any losses. Thank you. Time to get Siegfried into the fight, because Latimer is not going to hold with another unit charging. That's a big two-star approaching the skirmishers. I need to get them some help. Seams is getting shot up at the northern VP. I need to shift guys towards my left flank, since the right flank is well under control. Jackson, Nicholas, Rhodes, and Latimer should be able to keep collapsing the Union left flank. I'm going to pull my cav out and let them rest too once this skirmisher is gone. I'll put Pew into the fortification to brace for this charge. Scribner's already lost two guns.
Thank you.
Wilcox is on my far left flank and has double melee perks, so I'm not really worried about that AI unit charging on that flank. The AI artillery batteries are exposed now, so I can get some fire on them. Bernie is routing, so I'm going to charge with Nicholas. Ferrero and that dedicated skirmisher are both wavering. Hopefully both flanks will be collapsing soon. Scribner is down 3 guns now, and Nicholas is wounded. I think that's my first officer lost in this battle. Leisure's 2nd Brigade is heroic, but everyone else is getting worn down and most are out in the open now.
Come on.
Ford needs more rest, but Hobson can be pressed into a fight once this flank routes. And Hobson is wounded, so there's my 2-officer minimum for this battle. Ferrero shattered, so I'll go after the skirmisher and maybe the supply wagon.
Fire!
I can get flanking shots on that heroic unit now because he's turning to fire on my cav. It's mass charge time. I'll send my melee and one-star units first, then my two-star shooters, then my cav. A dedicated skirmisher routed south. I'll see if I can track him down. I had 1,209 killed, 3,930 wounded, and 539 missing, for a total of 5,678 casualties. The AI had 19,005 casualties and 14,404 captured. Only two infantry brigades were not captured. DHL made it to Lieutenant Colonel, so I'll have a 3-star for First Corps Commander for Antietam. Thank you so much for spending some of your valuable time watching today. I hope you found something useful for your campaigns, and I wish you much success, Generals.